Here's something unexpected. It's a Douglas pedal, but it's not a distortion. It's also not a compressor. It's actually a clean bass preamp and an interesting piece of Douglas history. So let's pull out another ancient Douglas piece and give those two a go. This is the new harmonic booster by Douglas. Those who have studied bass pedal history in school of spending thousands of years on bass gear might be aware that this one here actually isn't news. Before it was discontinued, the harmonic booster was one of the first three pedals that Douglas Castro released back in the day when he was a kid. And I mean that quite literally. He designed this when he was in his early 20s and probably started when he was still in his teens. The harmonic booster is also an interesting and sentimental piece of history for myself. When I started this channel, it was one of the first three demo videos that I ever shot. Don't look it up, it's not on the channel anymore. I deleted it among probably 100 others once I figured out how to make actually good videos. So here it is, the new harmonic booster, titled as a clean bass preamp, and yes indeed, it's very very clean. I looked up some old pictures of the original version on Google to see what the controls were back then, because there were actually different versions of this pedal. But here's one like I used in my video. When I clicked on this picture, a PDF of a bass pedal review popped up on my screen, and guess who wrote it? Yeah, that was apparently me. I totally forgot about that. Also check this old Ash Bass ad at the end, I mean the Poseidon, it's just outrageous. However, enough about me and the old days. It's 2019 and nothing about this pedal seems ancient or dusty or anything like that at all. So since it's called a booster, let's check its boosting capabilities. The booster is used to drive tube amps into distortion. This is mainly a guitar thing, but as you've just witnessed, you can achieve exactly the same thing if you're putting it in front of a distortion pedal. It adds more gain and causes the distortion to go beyond of its own natural capabilities. But of course you don't need any distortion to enjoy this pedal. In itself it's just a very clean and fantastic sounding bass preamp. This is something I would use any day if I'd like to add an active preamp to a passive bass but don't want to mess with the original state of the instrument. Seriously, don't mess with your beautiful vintage basses. Leave them as they are and get an output preamp like this one here instead. One thing I need to address is how nice this pedal looks. I really dig the Apple type brushed aluminum thing Douglas is going for usually, but this year making the whole thing black and leaving the edges aluminum-y looking, I think that's very tasty. So let's have a quick look at the controls. The layout is plain and simple. You got your boost, which adds gain. You got a freeband EQ with semi-parametric mids that allows you to select a mid-range that works for whatever you're looking for to achieve with your tone. And we have another control called character. I'm not entirely sure what it is technically. When it's turned all the way down, you get your flat bass signal, and the more you dial it in, your signal gets rid of sharp highs and what is on many amps called presence. The effect is similar to what happens when you mix a mic cap to your clean bass DI track. It doesn't sound like a cabinet simulation, but again, it has a similar effect on your signal. To break it down in some easy words, it takes the edge off, which is particularly useful in combination with distortion. I've mentioned before, the disc preamp is very clean. It seems to open up your bass tone to harmonics that weren't there before. That's where the harmonic part in the name comes from. It makes your bass sound more direct, as if there's nothing in between your strings and the speaker. For some sounds, it might actually be too direct, too open, too much in your face, but in this case, the character control here actually becomes very handy. This one here is actually an early production model, so don't be surprised if yours won't have written flat and enhanced here. These descriptions will disappear in future production runs. If you want to put this on your board, this should be the first pedal after your bass, and in this position it also functions as a buffer, of course only when it's engaged. If you already own a buffer, don't sell it right away, just put it in between your last pedal and the amp, and yeah, just try it out and thank me later. There's one more thing I want to mention. During the recording session for the pedal, I noticed that it just makes every bass sound better, no matter if it's active or passive. So be warned, once you're using this, it becomes increasingly hard to switch it off. I can see scenarios where you actually want to have two of them, just using one as a booster for solos or just to get more grit out of your distortions, but at the same time, never really want to miss the whole thing out of your signal chain, ever. So that's it. Yeah, if you have any questions regarding the harmonic booster or anything else really, just put them in the comment section below. I will gladly get back to you. And yeah, if you like this video, subscribe to this channel if you want to see more. That's it from me today. See you next time. Bye bye.